The top seven things not to do at a car dealership, especially when the market is overpriced. Welcome, it's the amazing Elizabeth from the Homework Guide team. In our previous video, we encouraged everyone to keep and fix your current ride. We still do, but if you must find a new car, we wanted to give you a how-to video to game plan your purchase. Let's roll. Number one, don't enter the dealership without a plan. And this goes without saying. And in this car market, you need to know if the dealer you're visiting even has any cars on their lot and the kinds you want to see. This is absolutely the worst time in history to start making impulsive car buying decisions. Start by writing down what you don't have in your current vehicle. Not enough seats for the family, not enough towing capacity, you need four-wheel drive this year, the doors are falling off. Now get online and check things out. Know what your options are for new and used, even if you'd have to drive to another state to get it. When the sales staff pressure you by saying, "You went and find another one of these for 500 miles," you can say, "That's okay, I'm willing to go that far." Call your own bank or credit union and ask for the value of the vehicle you're looking at buying. Remember, banks haven't adjusted their book values and you can't finance over 110 or 120% of the actual cash value of a vehicle. If the dealer is charging $25,000 for a vehicle that the bank says is only worth $20,000, you'll have to put down enough cash to cover the taxes, fees, and the extra $5,000 markup. Check out the math. With a vehicle price at $25,000, 6% sales tax, 8% interest rate at a 5-year loan, the loan amount would be $26,500. But that $26,500 is 132% of the actual value of the car, according to the bank. The highest you can likely finance is $23,000, which is 115% of the actual cash value of $20,000. Looking at the calculator, you'd have to put a minimum of $3,500 cash down to make the math work, and add to that all the taxes, fees, registration, and the bogus markups and fake fees that dealers are getting away with right now. More to come in a future episode. Number two, don't let the salesman steer you to a vehicle you don't want. Especially when it's slim pickings out there, salesmen may focus on getting you to buy whatever they have on hand today instead of helping you find what you really need. Remember, even if you have to find a different way to work for a few days or a couple weeks, you don't have to buy the wrong car today and be stuck with it for years to come. With how high car prices are right now, it will be easier than ever to be upside down in your car loan with negative equity. It would stink to buy a car you don't want, and then you can't get rid of the darn thing because you can't afford to trade out. Who knows where the market is going? The Homework Guide team agrees that this market will have to crash eventually. It's a matter of how long until it does, and how bad will the aftermath be. Number three, don't discuss your trade-in too early. Remember, you can control the car deal. Park your car away from others and get out and start walking quickly. Don't let the salesman greet you at your car and start asking about trading it in. Call your own bank and ask what the actual cash value of your own car is. Look at the difference in value versus what you owe. If you owe more than it's worth, you do not belong at a car dealership. It's really hard to break the cycle of buy too much car, trade out too early, and roll the debt into a new loan and repeat. For example, if you own a vehicle with an actual cash value of $10,000 from the bank and you owe $12,500 on the vehicle, you'd be putting $2,500 of debt forward into the new car loan, and that's if the dealer actually gets you the $10,000. On the calculator, you'd put in negative $2,500 for the trade-in, showing the debt going forward, and now your loan is at 128% of the actual cash value of the new car, and that's just not going to work. Listen, take the $3,500 cash you have, pay off the vehicle and use the $1,000 to repair your vehicle so it gets you another 12 to 18 months down the road. The car market should be a different place by then. And if the salesman gives you more than your trade is worth, expect them to greatly overprice the new car too, and vice versa. And if they give you a deal on the new car, they will try to steal your trade-in. Mum's the word for the best deal, and some dealers are even saying they won't sell you a car right now without a trade-in. Just whip out your car payment calculator from our website, thehomeworkguide.com, and be smart. Number four, don't give the dealership your car keys or driver's license. People are struggling to get test drives these days. Some of the comments are outrageous. Some dealerships are saying you have to give them your keys, your driver's license, or even a cash deposit up front to show that you're a serious shopper, just to test drive. But you don't legally have to do any of that. Trust your gut and walk away if you need to. If you were to give them your driver's license, they can pull a soft credit check on you. It's not legal, but it happens a lot. If you must, give them a copy of your driver's license with your birth date and address already blacked out. They can see it's you in the picture, that you can drive a car legally, but they can't pull their backroom shenanigans on you. Also, write in big letters in the copy, "No credit check authorized." It's less common now for dealerships to hide your keys, but it has happened before and could happen to you. Tell them that since you're parked at the dealership, of course you have to come back to get your car, right? So no need to give them your keys. And the cash deposit? Unless they've already quoted you a reasonable price and you're dang sure you want this new car, don't do it. And if you do have to do a deposit of any kind at any point in a car deal, always do it on a credit card because these charges can easily be disputed and reversed. Number 5, don't let the dealership run a credit check. If you watch our videos regularly, you should know to arrive at the dealership with cash, turn into a cashier's check, or a pre-approved car loan amount from your own bank or credit union. You shouldn't be finding out what you qualify for at a dealership, especially not now. If you have a loan or are paying cash, you 100% do not need a credit check at a car dealership for any reason. Check out our videos. Don't let car dealers ruin your or abuse your credit, and don't fill out a credit app at car dealers if paying with cash or outside financing. Ta-da! If you do need to consider a loan from the dealer, make sure you authorize the credit pull by signing for it. If you have multiple dealers run a hard pull on your credit and you don't buy a car within 30 days, it will negatively affect your score. Choose wisely. Number 6, don't engage in monthly payment negotiations. Focus on the overall cost of the vehicle. It keeps you and the sales staff from cramming yourself into the wrong vehicle, like a big dude in a clown car. Talk it over with your own bank first, way back at the start. Have them show you your car payments and loan terms available. You'll also need to know how much cash down you'll need to overcome these inflated prices, like we talked about earlier. Going back to that example, if the monthly payment for a 5-year loan is $466 and you tell a dealership, I can only afford $400 a month, what do they do? They set the loan at 6 years or 72 months. Listen, if you don't have an extra $66 a month right now, you're not going to have $400 a month for another year of your life. Number 7, don't feel you have to buy right now. And this is by far the most important. No one wants to waste their time dragging out the car buying process, but you don't have to waste your money or ruin your credit score either. There's always another option. Fix your current car and wait a year or get a ride from a friend for a few days so you can think things over. Yes, the car market is tight and competitive. And if you don't buy it today, someone else could come in tomorrow and take it. C'est la vie. If it's meant to be, it'll be. A lot of people also buy a new car in warmer weather to get ready for winter. But if you can hold out, there are generally more incentives in the winter months since, well, who wants to go car shopping in boots, scarves, and mittens? Auto shows also take place in winter, so watch for rebates to entice buyers to head to dealers. And don't forget that car dealers have to make payments on their inventory too. If you go at a slower time of year, they might just discount the car you're after so they can stop making their own payments on it themselves. And although currently less influencing, watch for discounts and rebates. Say you want a 2021, check out when the 2022s are due to arrive and see if you can get a 2021 a month or two before the new ones hit the ground. Good luck out there. Comment below if you get a screaming good deal so other viewers can benefit from your experience too. All right, if you appreciate our no-nonsense video today, consider giving us that great big thumbs up, and please, always remember to comment on our videos and share them with your family and friends. Views and comments really matter because they boost our searchability and help others find great Homework Guy content too. The entire Homework Guy team is here to represent you, the car buyer, and that's what we love to do. Thanks everyone for coming back. We'll see you in our next video. As Kevin always says, you guys rock. I'm the amazing Elizabeth. Gotta go.